Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 I want to welcome every one of you to our Global Day of Fasting and Prayer. PNUR Global Day of Fasting and Prayer. I want to thank all of you who were with us all throughout the August special. We had it at 1 day's fasting. And I want to tell those who are joining the PNUR family newly that we fast globally every Thursday. And we make it very simple. You can fast 6 to 12 noon every time. And one of the things we do is to remind you the essence, why it is necessary you join in this fast. You know, and I will be taking my reading today from Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 10. It's a popular scripture. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything, to stand. Stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Take note of the verse 18, the last verse we read today. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions, with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the lost people. Unfortunately, some people don't understand that the prayer is part of the armor of God. And if you notice the context used here, it didn't say the armors of God. It said the armor of God. So all the things mentioned here, the helmet, the sword of the Spirit, the belt of truth, the shield of faith, the breastplate of righteousness, all of them are part of one armor. And you make yourself vulnerable if you move forward and one part of the armor is not with you. And now something he said there, I want to hold very firmly. He said in your relationship with God, if you relate with God the way you should, there's an available strength for you. And so the writer here says, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. To be strong in the Lord is the command he gave. I have some basic training in boxing and kung fu. And one of the things you learn in boxing is your step and your standing, your gait, the way you can stand. So you will not fall off, so it cannot push you down. And the way you can stand, movement becomes easy for you. You can easily dodge punches. And I think that is why he says here, he said, be strong in the Lord and his mighty power. He said, take such a position in the Lord so you can draw the strength you need from the Lord. Position yourself in such a way that you can take what is available to you in the Lord. That's a very interesting thing. And now, every believer needs to understand that the Christian life has no place of passivity. The Christian life has no place to be docile, to just stand there and hope that God will help you or hope that God will deliver you. It's a command he made there. You be strong in the Lord. Do something that will make you strong in the Lord. Take position that will make you strong in the Lord. The next thing he said there is also a command. He said, put on the armor of God. He said, the full armor of God. Like I told you, that the armor is the word armor, even though it's a compound word, is in singular tense, that it says put on the full armor. So the armor of God does not come spontaneously. It does not come just because you get born again. So people say once you're in Christ Jesus, you have the armor of God. It is not true. The church the Apostle Paul was talking to here is the church of Ephesus. And if you know the history of that church, it's a church rooted in the word of God and the power of God. Apostle Paul said they fought wild beasts in Ephesus. In 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 32, he said he fought wild beasts in Ephesus. In Ephesus, Apostle Paul did great miracles in Ephesus. In Acts chapter 19, verse 11, Bible recorded how great miracles happened through his ministry. That even cloud touched his body, went to people, and they got healed. In Ephesus, Apostle Paul dealt with the root of witchcraft. Those people were used to witchcraft and diabolic oppression. In Ephesus, that's where they had the shrine of Artemis, or somebody called it Diana, Diana of Ephesus. And the all kind of persecution that Apostle Paul endured in that place. In Ephesus, there was one time an uprising against Apostle Paul and the gospel in Ephesus. So the people that Apostle Paul is talking to, they are in tandem, they are in the know of what it means to have opposition, to have resistance. And Apostle Paul now said, if you are going to be able to stand and to leave impact as I left in Ephesus, or in prayer in Ephesus to function, then you have to take a decision to put on the whole armor of God. And he gave it as a command. Now, he said that whatever challenge he faced in Ephesus, and whatever challenge the church in Ephesus is facing, or whatever challenge we are facing today, they are sponsored by some hidden spiritual forces. And that is why a person that I have not known how to fight spiritually is always a puppet in the hand of the devil. Let me say it again. A man or a woman that have not known how to fight spiritually is always messed up by the enemy. That's why some people are giving up in life. There are some people that are committing suicide. Some people are packing out of marriages. Some people are destroying their life. Some people are going to take drugs. Some people are doing some terrible things because they look at the life matters from the way they see it. You know, to understand what Apostle Paul is saying here. He said, if you are going through a battle as we went through, these battles are sponsored by some spiritual forces. And you need to understand this thing. I don't want to go too far with this, but if you are a pastor or you are a believer, or those of you who are entering a new territory, or you are facing challenges in your life, until you are able to understand what Apostle Paul is saying here, that everything happening around you has a spiritual undertone. Either they are pushed in by God or they are pushed in by the devil. But when I use the word push, I don't mean that God pushes himself on you. God makes an open proposal. That's why Jesus Christ said, come to me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Jesus makes a proposal. Devil deceives you into a contract. Devil manipulates. Devil shows you things that would entice you to accept him and to bring to your life. And then he will ruin your life. But now, he said that if there's a struggle you're facing with your Christian life, with your career, with your marriage, with your health, that these things are sponsored by some hidden evil forces. And I said again, a man that have not learned how to fight spiritually will not be able to make it in life. And I pray that God will help you today to understand that you need to know how to fight spiritually. And that is why Apostle Paul said here, you need to put on the full armor of God. And he says again, verse 13, therefore put on the full armor of God. He repeats that again and says, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything to stand, take the punctuation. Most of this punctuation is not in King James Version. He said, I'll tell you that again, verse 13. Therefore put on the full armor of God, comma, so that when the day of evil comes, comma, you may be able to stand your ground, comma, and after you have done everything, comma, to stand. So now, put on the full armor of God so that you may be able to stand in the day of evil. Now, the writer here says, you can't avoid the evil day. There will always come the evil day. The Lord Jesus Christ didn't deceive you. It's you, the Christian, that often deceive yourself to believe that you are going to a place where the devil will not disturb you and worry you. In the account Jesus Christ gave in Matthew chapter 7, from 24, he talks about two builders. One built his house on the rock. One built his house on the ordinary ground. But none of those buildings escaped the storm, the rain, and the wind. All of them faced it. And here, Apostle Paul is telling the believers and telling you that evil day will come. We are just trying to come out of the coronavirus pandemic, and we see a global economic crackdown and situations all over the world. You hear hostile things happening all over the place, wars and violence and all kinds of killing. And all this thing tells us that evil day will come. And Apostle Paul said here in the Bible that the only way to be able to stand is if you are putting on the whole armor of God. He said, so you'll be able to stand. And he said, after you've done everything, you should keep standing. I told you when I started that God's idea to the Holy Spirit is that you take a position so you can stand. To stand is a command. To stand is not a suggestion. To stand is not an appeal. And that is why he said, you put on the full armor of God. Now, in verse 14, he says, stand firm then. That you see, the way he keep repeating this stand. Stand, stand, stand. And if you look at the rest of the armor, I'll just be brief, summarize that. The belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the sword of the spirit, the boot you're carrying, the shield of faith, and the prayer. All these things we are provided, but there was nothing provided for the back. God does not intend that you flee from the devil. God does not intend that you withdraw from attacks. God intends that you take your stand and put the devil where he belongs. And I want to encourage you today, in today's fasting and prayer, that you use this opportunity to put the devil where he belongs. You need to buckle up and put the devil in his right position. And that is why he says stand. And I want to say that the last thing he made there, he said, are you praying? And you keep on praying. So I want to ask us, you just pray 31 days fasting. Why are you fasting? Fasting again, he said, as you pray, you keep on praying. It's part of the armor. And a man of prayer will find it easier to escape from sin. A man of prayer will find it easier to get direction from God. A person of prayer will find it easier to overcome the powers of the devil. A person of prayer will more easily receive heavenly support, will receive divine assistance. So the apostle here mentioned prayer as part of the armor. He said, you keep on praying. So I'm encouraging all my partners, wherever you are, you're hearing me today, to put on the full armor of God and keep on praying. Make sure you line out your prayers. Make sure you say something, say something, say something. Don't allow the devil deceive you. You are too busy. If you cannot pray spontaneously, write down the prayer topics. Make our time to go to a place and pray about a thing. I also want to encourage you. You need to have a prayer partner. You can reach us on the platform. We have some numbers we are public before our admin. You can call them for prayer. You can send in your prayer topic. Make this thing a serious business. When the Lord Jesus Christ said in Matthew 7, verse 7, he said, ask, you shall receive. It means there should be a specific thing you're asking from the Lord. Don't make your prayer general. You must learn to yield yourself in prayer. And let me tell you something before I round up. Covenant prayer is a covenant. Don't break the prayer chain. If you belong to this family, make sure you are fasting. If you're not in this family, take this matter serious. And I want to tell you that we are praying for you. We have received testimony. I want to announce to you that our brother Ninka Shokan has been healed. He has recovered from the affliction in his life. There are many testimonies also that we will be hearing on the platform very soon. So thanks to all of you who prayed. And that doesn't mean that our prayer has received answers. He also has been going on around the world, and God has kept all of us safe. We have never lost anybody on our network. And we thank God. It's not because we are better than other people, but because God is showing us extraordinary love, and we are doing what we are doing today. We are people of prayer. I want to encourage you to remain praying. Remember, it's your brother, my angel, and also at PNUR.org, +234 8035724. 4526. Remain under his anointing in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.